The name Mercury One comes from many things. I told you earlier at the beginning of the show that it comes from, space, the Mercury space project in the 1960s. It comes from my idea that by the end of the decade, we can return man not from the moon to Earth, but return man from this insanity to his own personal freedom. But it's difficult. But the one thing that we have to get down is we are entering a time of profound darkness and profound miracles. And it requires us to be relentless on all fronts. Relentless. I'm leaving after the broadcast tonight to go back over to my office, right about six blocks away, where we are having a charity fundraiser, one that you haven't heard about yet. Because I'm not asking you for money. We've invited a whole bunch of our rich friends. We're just going to wring the money out of them tonight for cancer, something that Tanya and I believe deeply in because of personal brushes with cancer in our friends, in our company, and also our good friend John Huntsman. We found something that is amazing. It is not a partial cure. It may be a total cure. A total cure. Mercury One believes in thinking big, but also thinking about the one, the individual. Tonight, a story of a man who dreamed big, bigger than most. He thought differently. He thought outside the box. And because of that, that thinking, that dedication, may one day soon change and save the lives of millions all over the planet. Watch. John Kanzius has a passion for radio and television. He managed and owned multiple TV and radio stations all across the country and was dedicated to keeping up to date with the latest broadcast technology. But after four decades, he was ready to retire. He was looking forward to throwing out his alarm clock, afternoon tea times, evenings with his wife, Marianne, and visits from his children and grandchildren. He thought he was heading into his golden years, but it wasn't in the cards. What John thought was just a pulled muscle ended up being the first warning sign of terminal leukemia. His days quickly went from golf swings to chemotherapy and radiation, and the side effects were devastating.
I always say that he was either on chemo or surviving chemo. And those who know him know that he was a fighter.
John knew how radio waves worked from his years in the business. And because as a child he would build radios from scratch, he wondered, what if you could destroy cancer cells using radio waves? Because of his chemo treatment, he had trouble sleeping and would spend nights researching his theory. He was normally very quiet while he worked, but one night was different. He was up making such a racket in the kitchen that Marianne woke up and went to see what was going on.
He was making a ruckus because he was cutting into a heavier pie pan and creating a disc. And he has radio equipment downstairs, and I still have it. But in doing this, this was the noise I was hearing. Then he took a transmitter and he strung a wire between these two. And in doing so, then activated the heat and put the hot dog in between the two of them. And with the copper sulfate, and heated it, and where he put the copper sulfate was where the hot dog became cooked, and the rest of the hot dog was cold.
He had discovered a new way, possibly to treat cancer. His garage became a laboratory, and he went to work testing and developing his theory. He teamed up with two major research universities, the University of Pittsburgh Medical Center and MD Anderson Cancer Center at the University of Texas. The experiment with a hot dog suddenly turned into something much, much bigger. Here's how it works. A cancer patient is injected with gold nanoparticles, each with an antibody attached. The nanoparticles are extremely small, and once injected, take about 45 seconds to circulate throughout the entire body. Traveling through blood vessels, they go to the malignant tumor. Each antibody attaches itself to a molecule on the surface of a cancer cell, and the nanoparticles are pulled into the cells. The patient is then exposed to a radio field, which heats up just the nanoparticles and kills just the cancer cells. Preliminary findings show that 100% of the cancer cells are destroyed, and there is zero damage to the surrounding healthy tissue. Unfortunately, John lost his battle to cancer in 2009 before his treatment could become a reality. But Mary Ann is carrying out John's work.
The day he asked me to take on this project, I told him I would because he just seemed so intent about it. He's a listen to me. You always listen to the children, but you don't listen to me. I want you to do this. Nobody understands cancer like you did. You have walked the walk with me. I want you to see this through.
One man, one idea, one goal. Change the way we look at modern medicine. Proof that visionaries and heroes are among us.
Can you believe you've never heard that story before? For more on this story and the breakthrough cancer treatment, go to glennbeck.com right now.
GBTV. The truth lives here.